In 2008, my family lost her home in the financial crisis. I was in high school at the time, and overnight, we went from normal to nearly homeless. Experiences like that expose just how fragile our systems really are. They leave you with a question that could follow you for the rest of your life. Is there a better way? Now that question, it set me on a lifelong journey. I searched for alternatives, for safer systems, for fairer structures, ways for people to have ownership that couldn't just disappear when larger institutions failed. That search, it eventually introduced me to cryptocurrency, a decentralized finance, and to a vision that is much bigger than digital money. It's the vision of tokenization. Now, before I go further, I want to be very clear. I'm not a financial advisor, and nothing I'm sharing today should be taken as financial advice. What I'm sharing is an idea about how technology could reshape ownership and communities. So, what exactly is tokenization? Put simply, tokenization is a process of taking something that exists in the real world, a home, a bond, a piece of art, even a community, and representing it digitally on the blockchain using tokens. Ownership becomes flexible, divisible, transferable. Instead of one large rigid asset that is difficult to buy, sell, or share, tokenization allows ownership to become broken into smaller digital pieces that could be exchanged almost as easily as sending an email. And this shift is not theoretical. Tokenization is currently happening in real estate, it's happening in fine art, music royalties, private equities, and even concert tickets, transforming how people invest, trade, and participate in ownership. For years, our communities have been living on borrowed land. Many online platforms today, they own your group, your chat, even your membership. What feels like your community often isn't, because the tools, the data, sometimes even the connections themselves belong to someone else. Tokenization changes that. Communities can become self-sovereign. Instead of users of someone else's platform, they become owners of what they build. Right now, when most people, when they hear about tokenization, they hear it in the context of finance, like tokenized gold, stable coins that represent money, real estate and stocks. But the larger potential of tokenization lies beyond finance, because what happens when we apply it not just to assets, but to communities and culture? Imagine a group of people gathering around something they care deeply about, whether it's health, art, storytelling. Traditionally, if that community wanted to grow, if it wanted to host events, launch programs, or build something larger, it would need outside funding. That might come from sponsors or grants or investors, but all those come with conditions and strings attached. Tokenization could flip that model with careful design and roles. Instead of outsiders determining the group's future, the community funds itself. Members don't just pay to join, they hold a real stake in its success. And this shift is already happening. Creators are experimenting with social tokens where fans can directly support and invest in their journey. Cultural collectives like to use tokens, not as subscriptions, but as keys into a network that gives them access to online and offline events, support, networking. Even nonprofits are beginning to explore tokenization, using it to let donors see and track and even co-own the impact of the projects they fund. When I think about this, I often go back to something personal from my own life. In college, I started a concert promotion company. I started hosting music events for Las Vegas locals. Now I imagine, what if we use tokenization to vote on which performer we'd like to see, to fund bigger and larger event experiences? You could own a stake in the success of the company. You'd be members with defined access and governance rights. That's what tokenization makes possible. It lets groups, whether a high school group, a artist collective, a wellness community, not only gather, but own what they built together. It's also important to understand that tokenization, it's not magic. It can have real risk. A responsible approach emphasizes a utility, access, governance. It makes no promises of returns. It minimizes speculation and respects the local laws. And the deeper meaning of this isn't about money. It's about culture, it's about people. For thousands of years, humans gathered around campfires for warmth, for safety, for the telling of stories. Today, the campfire may be digital, but the principle is the same. Tokenization doesn't replace a fire, it fuels it. It provides new ways to support trust, to exchange value, and to keep belonging rooted in the people who create it. The technology is just the matches. The energy, the connection, the creativity, that's us. So picture again the community you care about most. This time, it doesn't rely on outside funding. It sustains itself. It thrives because everyone has a genuine stake in its success. That is the power of tokenization, not just for assets, but for identity, belonging, and purpose. Thank you.